Hey, what's up guys, this is Daddy Cool and you are watching Satisfactory with the subtitle Megafactory Online. Now in previous episode I have created a couple of blueprints. So one of them is for iron plate production, the other one is iron rod, and the third one is just screw production. And I have put these layouts into this area here, and all of them are placed just to create reinforced iron plates in these four assemblers, and the purpose of those is to connect the finished product into these three assemblers, which are gonna produce the modular frames. Now the plan for this episode is to extend power production, which I am lacking at the moment. I'm in the proper level of power production, and I'm gonna look for coal resource for that, and maybe water, and place some kind of a electricity production hub in that area. And of course, first of all, I would like to finish this side of the production here, and once the power production is stabilized, I will come back and try to focus on the space elevator project. So let's do this. So first of all, I also noticed something here that I am missing one splitter here from the system, and now it's working nicely. Let's go to this storage and I'm gonna put the conveyor belt into here, basically connecting it like this, and I will take everything on this line. Come on, there you go. And probably this is a proper spot for that. Let's get that from there. And the question is how to feed these machines here. I think that's the best idea and the easiest way that I have in mind. Let's put a splitter here. Resource coming from the back. Like that. Connect those. Yeah. And I think I will be able to connect that one into there, and now reinforced iron places on the proper place. I'm gonna put a splitter here as well, gonna be feed it from my direction, I mean this direction, like that, and all three of them are in the spot. Just like that, and put an upgraded conveyor belt into here. So basically I think the assemblers here are working already. I mean, will start to work very shortly. And I'm gonna put the mergers here, collecting the finished product. And you're gonna come into my direction. Okay. And if I am correct, this storage will be filled with finished products very shortly. So that one's working, and that one is working. Very nice. So the other thing I wanted to do here very shortly, I'm gonna feed these machines with raw resources. I have a couple of those that I received from dismantling and upgrading things. So So let's just feed them here for the precious space, inventory space. I cannot go here through. Let's go around. This one's full. This one. Now it's okay. I still have some iron ore in hand. Can I go up? Yeah. That's not the machine I was looking for. Maybe this one. Oh, yeah. Here we go, and here we go. Now that's okay. Cannot go out in there. Let's go this way. Okay, so everything is prepared here upstairs. I'm gonna check the things down here. Like there's a production line here which is not working, but I'm not gonna disassemble that just yet. Still, I would like to collect some things in the upper region. Come on, hop, hop, hop. Okay, let's collect those, sort some things out. Let's collect these things. Yeah, these one can also go. Wow, lots of things here. So efficiency is not on our side at the moment in this area, but that's still okay. I'm gonna put these things here. Yep. Maybe let's take one out. Okay. These one I wanted to put into there. Let's sort out things once again. Put that in, that's okay, and I think I'm more or less fine with that. Okay, what do we have in here? Production has stopped for the wire cables, it's just low. Wow, full of cables. Not have enough inventory space. I think I just connect this. Oh, that's not good. What's the proper place? This. Now it's okay. This. And feed it into here so that I do not have to take it by hand. And I'm gonna put a couple of things in here. Okay. So let's just check the biomass burner, but I think the resources are very low in there. So that's not really helpful for me at the moment. Construct this. The resources in here are more or less okay, but they are shrinking very fast. And yeah, there are no leaves at all and only a few wood storage. And that's a problem, but we will solve it very shortly. Let's just check the quantities here of this. Yeah, deconstruct. And what are the requirements for coal power? Okay, I have to look for rotors and reinforced iron plates. Okay, that's not gonna be a problem. And production here, okay. Pipeline, okay. I'm gonna take a couple of copper sheets too. So rotors, reinforced iron plates and copper sheet is the ones I'm looking for. Whoa, a lot of pieces of this. Let's take them. Rotors, okay. 300 and a little bit more. Okay, and copper sheets, that's the thing. And then I can look for a place to position coal power. Come on, copper sheet is on that way. Yeah, I can go. Take all, that's okay. So, I have some copper production in that area, and probably that's gonna be a good start. I mean, here's the map, space elevator. I think copper is somewhere coal is somewhere here, and maybe if I find something on this area that would be really good, because here we have water and that's gonna be a proper solution, and I also have cables leading here, so that's something we can start with. So let's just go. Okay, so I'm gonna follow this coal conveyor belt here. Unfortunately, the iron ore that I have directed for producing the modular frames is, I mean, was using up for some steel production, and that is not producing at the moment, which I am not really happy about. But maybe that's a new possibility. I mean, if this coal is not being used up, I can use it for electricity production if I direct it in a different way, in case I do not find any more coal, but I doubt that there is no more coal in the close distance, but we will see very shortly. I will scan the area once I am up here, because that's the furthest point from my base that has electricity connected. Okay, so we have two coal there, normal, and the other one is pure, that's good, and impure. Of course I'm gonna go there, so that's the direction. Let's take some electricity with us. Yeah. So I suppose I have to go into the canyon. That's the way to go. Yeah. Go into that way. There is another resource and some enemies up there. That's the distance that the cable can handle. A couple of interesting things in here. I will definitely have to come back a little bit later. But I suppose I do not have enough resources to fully use up those two coal resources. I mean, here they are, and we have three enemies there. I have to fight them. Let's prepare for the fight. So one of them is here. Okay, handled. Let's check the other one. There you go. And there's the third one. That That's good. And we have an enemy here. Whoa, that's a stronger one. But not that strong. Okay, situations handled. And I can now place the coal production units. Miner twos. Yeah, just like that. And I'm gonna put this miner into system. I mean, electricity production system. Let's put a pole into here. And I'm gonna use the conveyor belt 3. Put it there. And probably lead it to here for now. And I'm gonna put a foundation here on the edge of the cliff. Let's put a 4 and the conveyor belt. Lead it here. Deconstruct, deconstruct, and now I'm pretty sure I will be able to deliver the resources as down as I would like to. Yeah, and I am looking for a proper position for the foundation. Yeah, that's okay. It's a little bit deeper. Here we go. Yeah. Did I place it just correctly? I mean, this height for the foundation is not good. This is the good, right? This doesn't go below water. I mean, it does. So that's the one, and basically there's not a big difference. Anyway, use the better one. I can change this just now. Okay, there's the coal. Let's go there. Like this. Okay, I'm gonna deconstruct these because I do not need them just yet. And concrete is precious material at the moment. So that's the point where the coal comes down, which means I'm gonna put the catwalk here and a couple of more foundation pieces here. That, maybe one more. Yeah. And now I can place the first coal generator into here, maybe one segment deeper, like that. Yeah, I just wanna position it correctly. Yeah.
Interesting. Most pioneers already had coal power set up by this point because they understood their responsibility to humanity. Adjusting pioneer attitude metrics. Reminder: coal power generators require coal.
Okay, basically she told that I'm not efficient enough because most pioneers already had coal production by this time. This means they were faster in creation things. Okay, good to hear that. So we have the coal production facilities here, and logistics conveyor lift. No, that doesn't need to be that fast. A conveyor belt MK1 is just enough, because as far as I know, coal power plants use 15 coals per minute. And actually I have 240 pieces of coal produced there upstairs, and the divided by 15, it's a lot, so I can put a lot of power plants into here from that coal. And let's just connect them with a splitter. Yeah, that's gonna be the method. Okay, and I'm gonna connect the fast conveyor belt into here. Yeah, I have enough resources to do so. That's good. I'm happy that I have gathered enough resources for all of these, because that's gonna be a big step in my progress. Okay, conveyor lift MK3 is the solution here, facing there, and you're gonna be connected in there. That's it. Now, the next step in this progress, I wanna create a lookout tower into here. Where's the ladder? I do not see the ladder. It should be here. Yeah. Put it there like that. And I'm gonna put a foundation into here so that I can go there. So the next step is to feed them with water. But before feeding water into the system, I want to connect this pole into... Oops, didn't want to jump down, but that's also okay. So put this there. And yeah, 15 units per minute, that's the value. And it requires water. So I wanted to create the water production near this area. Where should I put this? That's the good question. So head that way. Oh, that gives me an idea here. That's good. And the next one there.
That may indeed be water. Try submerging your arm. If it does not dissolve, that will narrow down the range of possibilities. Or you could just pipe it to a coal-powered generator and see what happens.
Okay, now that's a little bit tricky, how to put things down here into line. I'm gonna put this pipe here maybe. Yeah, that's gonna be okay. And at this side, it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Maybe into here. Is it straight? No, now it's a straight line, right?
Yeah. Fix-it pipelines can contain any fluid, including the water necessary for coal-powered generators. Note, water does not flow upwards by itself. While water extractors provide some lift to truly defy gravity, consider the use of pipeline pumps.
So the next thing, yeah, these pipeline directors like that, and let's connect pipeline into there and one into there, and the other ones I cannot really direct from here. I have to hop down once again. So connect that one in there, that one into there, that one into there, and that one into there. Now the tricky part is that I do not have too much capacity. I mean, I'm very close to the maximum production and usage, so I'm gonna put online only this one, and hopefully that's gonna produce enough water to fuel this coal power generator, and that this will solve my energy. Yeah, oh, it's already working. And we are online, that's good. So now the next step is to put the other machines also to production. There you go. Connect those, connect that. And I almost forget. Now we're talking. Capacity is increasing very nicely. So let's put one more pole in here. Connect those. Let's give power to that one. Grab that one. Okay. So what I can do now is to double this quantity. And yeah, that's the thing I will do. I have enough resources from basically everything to do so. And that's it's a good question if I should put everything on one line. I think I will do that, but regarding generators, I have to build more foundation here. Why are you facing that? Whatever. Okay, the thing is I'm using up concrete very fast, so that thing is gonna be missing for sure. So I think the best thing I can do is put one more coal producer into here, connect it with coal. Let's put a splitter into here, like that. Conveyor belt, feeding that one, it's nice. Let's put the pipe, connect this whole thing into a one, like this. And it's a good question if I can jump up. No, I cannot jump that high. have to put a ladder into here. Yep, like that. And the next thing is this junction there. Yep, that one is okay. Junction into here. Yeah. Another one into here. Oh, and I'm still missing one to there. So a junction comes into here. Once again, I have to create a hopper. Yeah, connect things together. Just like that. And I need electricity once again. I think I will hop a little bit higher this time, because it's easier to go on these buildings. Okay. What do we have here? Let's put that one there. I can connect, that's good. Let's connect that. That. Power to this. We're gonna feed that. And I will put one more pole into this location. Yeah, and just connect it like that. And now, basically, all of them should be working. And this is water and coal. Why are you not producing? Oh, it's no connection. There you go. Now, okay, all of them are producing properly. That's good. And there is one last thing I would like to do, just really fast, to set all the productions to 75%. And the reason for that is that currently these water extractors are producing too many water, and my pipeline system cannot really, it can handle the quantity, but the coal power productions do not require that much water. And this one I'm gonna set into, let's say, 80%, and that's gonna be the very small surplus that I really like to have, just in case, you know. And if I am correct, let's check a power line here. Yeah, consumption is 700, capacity 1200, so that's really nice. And the good thing is that if I come back, I can double this area once at least, and that will just use up this coal quantity. And I can create it even once more on this side for those coal quantities, so that's really good. So just because everything is done here, let's collect the things I have gathered here, like that. And I do not want to go that area. How can I climb back? That's the big question here once again. Let's put a lookout tower here. I'm a big fan of this hate climbing like this. Let's put the foundation into here. Here. Yeah, and another lookout tower. Where are you? Here you go. Into there. Can I connect these? Yeah. Oh, that's very convenient. Okay, let's check it once more. So all of them are working. Water extractors are working. That's pretty cool. One problem less. So I wanna fight my way back. I really want to collect some resources, maybe new ones. That would be really good. Let's just take this power slug. Okay. There's not much thing happening in here. That's just a neutral enemy, and there is something up there. A red dot. Let's prepare the weapon. It's really hard to climb things here. There you go. It's done. There's another one. Bigger one. So far it seems. There you go. It's done. Let's just take this one.
The effigy's ripples through our temples, our veins nearly touch. It is shy, notes shall be taken and played.
From a certain perspective, your brain looks like it is processing language, but there is no auditory data. If you are hearing voices that are not mine, this is no cause for concern. It is a common side effect of extreme pressure and stress.
Okay, there is a power slug and it's purple actually, which I do not have yet collected. And actually I cannot even place it anywhere here. What's that? Copper ore. This one can go. So actually I can pick it up, but these enemies are just too many for me and I'm really not sure if I can fight them just yet. Let's avoid this fight. Oh, if I can. Yeah, let's take it. Whoa, I really have to run now away. That's not funny at all. Let's go through it here. Now hopefully I have lost them. Three of them is too much even for me. But that's okay. Something new has been found. Let's get back to the base. So this resource here is copper, which if I remember well, it was pure, right? Yeah. Pure copper ore resource, that's good. I will do something with that. There is also an enemy with a yellow power slug. and I do not feel like fighting it, especially because I do not have space to pick that bar slug up. Maybe next time when I'm going to check the energy production, but for now I'm really really very happy about that. The energy is on a stable level. So what's the situation in here? No iron rod. I think I have, and I have a lot of pieces being produced. Let's just hop here upstairs. This is do not need beam. Ah, whatever. First of all, fill things here. Modular frames, they were enough, and I am also producing them, so that milestone probably can be fulfilled. Only 12 pieces in here. I will check the other storage place very shortly. Put these into there. Sort things out. Put these into the container, the power slugs, this one, the coal, of course. What else? Not that much. I'm gonna create a couple of portable miners because I only have 2 pieces left, and just in case I wanna upgrade the mine, these will be used up. So it's the best idea to have some of them in hand, and I do not have to come back just for this. I don't like it when I do not have everything on hand when I need them. So let's create maybe 2 more. That's fantastic. So I wanted to check the quantity of reinforced iron plates and the modular frame quantities in here. So far everything is seemingly working fine. It's not much of reinforced iron plates. Let's check the modular frames as well. Oh, now that's the quantity. And let's check this machine. Oh, I understand. So the reason for having so low reinforced iron plates is that the assemblers are totally filled up now because it's overproducing and everything is delivered to the machines, and they are keeping 300 pieces in the inventory at the moment, so that has to be fed up somehow. So it was not 42 pieces ready, but maybe 342 actually. Anyway, I can feed this and fulfill this mission.
Milestone reached. After several pioneers started exhibiting traumatic responses to power blackouts, fix it develop mitigation tools recommended by your local therapist. Power storages can hold excess power to delay or prevent blackouts in the eventuality that your factory's power consumption exceeds production. To simplify, these are rechargeable batteries. Power towers carry power lines for significantly greater distances than poles, facilitating factory expansion and exploitation of this environment for the good of Fixit and humanity.
Okay. So the next bottleneck of this production chain is concrete. So I'm gonna replace the miners to better ones and also change the production a little bit. Miner to 2. And here I'm gonna deconstruct this building. Those together. Let's check the other one. I'm gonna do the same in there, And after that, I'm gonna concentrate production basically close to here, but this will also result an efficiency upgrade, not just because of the miners, or I mean basically because of the miners, but power consumption will be not that higher because the constructor can process 45 pieces of resources and the miner is producing 60, so I have to solve this thing first. I'm gonna deconstruct that part because I do not want to have limestone ore into the machines going. So all in all, let's put a constructor into here, another one into here, and the third one into here. Let's give them some power. Oh. So one, two, three. All of them are producing concrete, so 45. 3 times 45 is 135, and actually I'm receiving 120 pieces, so it's more or less efficient. I'm just gonna weight these pieces. Let's grab them, speed things up a little bit. Yeah, it's only ore left. And deconstruct this and this, and deconstruct this part, and that part. Now, I'm gonna put a splitter here, feeding from the back. Yeah. Where are you? Go. Come on. In there. So, feeding of the quantities. It's gonna be like this. I almost forgot to put these into here. So now they should be creating some stuff. I think I have the limestone in hand. Yeah. And put the merger here, leading that direction. It's basically okay. And like that once again. Okay, output is 45 altogether, so MK1 is just fine in here. Connect. And I can lead this into there. Take out the limestone ore like that. And now this area should be, yeah, working properly. I think it's doing so. So from now on I can connect this back, and the quantity is 45 pieces of limestone, which is basically more or less okay. So let's check the last mission for the hub. And I'm gonna fulfill that quest as well, for sure. There you go. Hypertubes, gonna unlock the hypertube elements. And the things to fulfill this is very easy already. I just have to get the copper sheets and some concrete beams, or what are those? Something like that. So let's just up here, up here. Yeah, more or less, yeah. There you go, one of those. Let's take two of those. And now I think this should be handled, right? Let's do this.
Milestone reached. By adding hypertube entrances at both ends of hypertubes, pioneers can achieve two-way travel between locations. They are also error percent safer than jump pads. You dreamed of moving across factories like valued resources, such as rocks and water, and Fixit listened to your dreams. We watched them. We took extensive notes. Hypertubes. Because Fixit makes pioneers' closely monitored dreams come true.
That's good. So, hypertubes are also available. And I wanna check the power slug, catarium, nutrition, no. Power slug, I need cables. And a yellow slug, which is not unlocked yet. So let's take the cables. And there you go, a yellow slug. Let's research it.
Research completed. Yellow power slugs are further into their life cycle than blue power slugs, and thus have more potential energy stored. They can now be processed into power shards.
Okay, and I have a purple one as well. Let's do that.
Research completed. Purple power slugs seem to be near the end of their life cycle and have a significant amount of potential energy stored. It is a good thing Fixit does not waste. Purple power slugs can now be processed into power shards.
Let's take that mushroom as well. I think I can research that one too. It's here, right?
This mushroom, dubbed bacon agaric due to its uncanny resemblance to raw bacon, is compatible with the human digestive system and has been added to the object scanner. Further research is available.
Yeah, I just need a couple of steel pipes for the next step. Let's take a couple of those.
Research shows potential for processing planetary nutrients for pioneer benefit. Nutritional inhaler research available.
Okay, and I have the mushrooms in hand, so nutrition's 04. Flower Here you go. So what does this do?
Nutritional inhaler recipe unlocked. Using this inhaler will restore health and also gives your skin a radiant glow that is connected to well-being and probably not radioactivity.
Probably. Probably not. Okay. Quartz I do not have enough. What about these? I think I have the necessary modular frames and 25 sulfur. Let's just do that one. There you go. And I hope the production is done with that. I have to run a lot, so probably in the next episode I'm gonna install a couple of hyper tubes for easier and faster, going one point to the other. Yeah, that seems to be a good idea. Not here, it was in here. And was it? Yeah, well, it was sulfur. There you go.
Research completed. Experimental power generation research options are now available. These may enhance performance of other fuel sources.
Okay, do I need a hard drive for this? Yeah. So to unlock this, the compacted coal, I need a hard drive and 25 coal. So this is something that I think I will do. Nothing I can do in here. Nothing I really can do in here. Yeah, I think that's all for now. Maybe this one, I did not match Stinger yet. And I need 5 foods. I can create that. Let's put this into there. I do not need those anymore. And neither this. So, yeah, in the workbench, I'm gonna create 5, right? 3, 4, 5. There we go. Let's do this really fast.
Research completed. Alien protein can now be turned into biomass or alien DNA capsules. In addition to being used for research, the invaluable alien lifeform data in these capsules can be traded for fix-it coupons at the Awesome Sink. We guarantee the best capsule to coupon exchange rate anywhere on this planet.
Okay, I can receive 6 inventory slots. Free food and a lot of cables, which actually I do have. So let's create these 3 pieces. 1, 2, 3. And I have all the cables in here. I am pretty sure. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, something like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 1,000 pieces. What's the requirement? So let's just do this. Oh, very nice.
Pocket dimension significantly expanded. I worked all afternoon analyzing the transdimensional confibulatory permutations of alien DNA to achieve this. We are all doing our part for fix it.
Okay. So I think this was all for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this episode. I think we have also stepped forward during this episode, and if you just feel like and would like to help me, just hit the like button or the subscribe button, and see you next time. Goodbye.